day, grade 12 students. We are still on week number 2 of Practical Research 2. And again, before we start with our new lesson, let us have first a prayer. Once again, good day, grade 12 students. We are still on week number 2 of Practical Research 2, and we are studying chapter number 2 of your research paper, which is all about learning from others and reviewing the literature. Okay, but before we start with our new lesson, let us do first a recap of what we have discussed in our last video. Okay, so answer first these questions to check your memory on how you understood our lesson. Okay, so the first question, what is the basis for the number of lines or arrows in creating conceptual framework? So the basis of numbers of lines or arrows in creating conceptual frameworks is your research questions. Okay, always remember that. Number 2, what are the different types of variables? Okay, we have independent, dependent, and then we have other variables which are called as mediator, moderator, and control variables. So it is important that you know each type of variable so that you can craft your conceptual framework easily. Okay, now we are going to our lesson number 3, which is all about research hypothesis. And for this lesson, we have this objective, this research hypothesis. Okay, so let's start with our discussion. Okay, what is or what are the research hypotheses? Okay, so research hypothesis is a prediction of the possible outcomes of the study according to Frankel and Wallen 2009. Okay, parang nag-ano tayo, citation. Hypotheses are statements in quantitative research in which the investigator makes a prediction or a conjecture about the outcome of the relationship among attributes or characteristics according to Creswell 2012. Okay? So, ang research hypothesis, para siyang educated guess. So, parang gumagawa tayo ng scientific investigation, di ba? Kailangan natin meron tayong hypothesis. Ito yung hula, parang hula siya, or prediction sa kung anong mangyayari sa iyong research. And ano yung magiging effect ng mga variables sa isa't isa. So, kailangan kasi isipin na natin, we have to think in advance what will happen in our research and what will be the result. Okay, so, sa ating huling part ng ating research, masasabi natin kung na-achieve or tama ba yung inisip mong hypothesis about your research. Okay, so, kailangan meron muna tayong prediction of what will be the outcome of our study. Okay. So, after writing your research question and doing preliminary research, you need to formulate the research hypothesis, especially when you are doing an experimental or correlational research. They should be clear, specific, testable, and must include the following elements: the relevant variables, the specific group being studied, and the predicted outcome of the experiment or analysis. Combes 2020. So, ano-ano ba yung kailangan na makita sa hypothesis aside from being clear, specific, testable, and measurable? So, meron siyang 3 elements: the variables, the specific group, and the outcome prediction of your study. So, paano nga ba masasabi na meron yan lahat na elements na iyong research hypothesis? Let us take a look at this. So, if the research you are making will involve statistical testing, a null hypothesis will also have to be written. It is a statement that says that there is no association between the variables. The null hypothesis is written as H sub O, while alternative hypothesis is H sub 1 or H sub A. Okay. So kapag gumagawa tayo ng katulad nito, statistical tayo kasi practical research too. So kailangan complete siya with null and alternative hypothesis. Yung none yung magsasabi na pagkatapos ng research na to, walang epekto yung ganitong variable sa ganitong variable. Yung alternative hypothesis natin, siya yung nagsasabi na merong epekto si variable A kay variable E. So for example, there is an effect with the hours of the study spent in the exam score. So yun ay alternative hypothesis. So pag tinanong natin, may epekto yung oras na ginugugol sa pag-aaral sa exam score. Okay, pag sinabi namang null hypothesis, ganito siya. There is no effect in the hours of spent studying with the exam score. Walang epekto yung haba o oras ng paggugol sa pag-aaral sa magiging exam score. Ganun siya. They are contradicting statements. So let us have this example para mas maunawaan. Okay? So we have here. Oh, for example, ang research question nyo ay, is there a significant relationship between the grade 11 student respondents' availability of internet connection at home and their average sleeping time? Okay, so, kunyari, yung focus ng study. Okay? So, meron bang epekto yung oras ng pagtulog ng mga grade 11 students na naging respondents ng iyong research sa pagkakaroon nila ng internet connection sa bahay? So, yan yung topic or yung question. So, ano yung null and alternative hypothesis natin para dyan? So, una, pag sinabing null, sasabihin mo na walang epekto yon. So, gagawin mo lang, there is no significant relationship between the grade 11 student respondents' availability of internet connection at home and their average sleeping time. Okay, so, nabanggit ba dyan yung tatlong elemento ng hypothesis? So, we have here the group of people involved, the grade 11 student. The variable is the internet connection and the average sleeping time. Okay, anong dyan yung independent? Independent yung internet connection kasi siya yung nagkakos ng effect dito sa dependent na average sleeping time. Okay, nasabi ba dyan yung predicted outcome? Yes, there is no significant. Yun yung predicted outcome. So, kompleto. And that is classified as null hypothesis kasi nga sinasabi na walang epekto yung pagkakaroon ng internet connection ng grade 11 students sa kanilang sleeping time. How about H sub A or the alternative hypothesis? Paano siya isusulat? So ganito na lang. There is a significant relationship between the grade 11 student respondents' availability of internet connection at home and their average sleeping time. So, ganun. Kinocontradict niya yung statement ng null hypothesis. So, sinasabi ng alternative hypothesis that there is a relationship. So, yan yung ina-assume mo na mangyayari sa pagkatapos ng research. Malalaman mo or pe-predict mo na meron niyang relationship yung pagkakaroon ng internet connection sa bahay ng grade 11 students sa kanilang average sleeping time. Okay? So, that is for our first example. Okay? Next one, what is the effect of hours of study to the score of students in exam? So, yung parang example na ginagamit natin sa mga una nating discussion. So, null hypothesis, kailangan ipakita na walang relationship yung mga variables. Okay, that's kailangan maipakita yung group, the variables, and the predicted outcome. Okay, so we have here, the number of hours spent by the students in studying class or in studying has no effect on their exam scores. Okay, asan dyan yung group, the students. So pwede pa yung specify kung sinong mga students. Asan na mga variables, we have hours spent in studying and the exam scores. Nasaan yung predicted outcome sa null hypothesis? Has no effect. Okay? Sa pag-alternative hypothesis naman, ganito lang siya. The number of hours spent by students studying has a positive effect on their exam score. Okay? So, binaliktad lang yung statement ng ating null hypothesis. Okay? So, kayo naman. Your turn. Unang question, is there a significant relationship between the SLRDA grade 11 students' final grade in general mathematics and their level of stress tolerance? So, yun yung unang example na research question. So, paano nyo siya gagawa ng null and alternative hypothesis? Okay? So, ganito siya. Okay, lagay natin. There, ang pagnal, there is no effect. Okay? Or there is no significant relationship between SLRDA grade 11 students' final grade in GenMat and their level of stress tolerance. Kaya naman, there is no possible effect, there is no possible outcome, ganun. So, alternative, there is a, ganun naman siya, significant relationship between the SLRDA grade 11 students' final grades in GenMat and their stress or level of stress tolerance. Okay? Next one, okay. Is there a significant difference between the male students' preferred professor's traits and that of female students? Okay, so pwede siyang ganito. Male students has no preference for professor's traits compared to female students. So, yun yung hypothesis. Pag alternative hypothesis naman, there is a difference between the prepared traits or professor traits of male students when compared to female students. So, kailan contradicting and parallel yung statements ng null and alternative hypothesis. Last one, is there a significant difference between the level of selling power of sample product prior to change in packaging and with the new packaging? Okay, so paano niya siya gagawan? So, ganito. Walang nabanggit dyan na variables. Respondents. So, kailangan natin maglagay. So, for example, the grade 11 students prefer or sabi natin the grade 11 students prefer to buy new package product compared to old package product. Okay, so, ano yun? Alternative. Paano yung null? Grade 11 students have no preferences when it comes to packaging of new product or old product. So, pwede na naman na ganito lang siya. There is a significant difference between the selling power of product, for example, of lipstick to the grade 11 students with its old and new packaging. Okay? Okay naman, there is a significant difference between the selling power of a certain product to grade 11 students to old packaging to the new packaging. So, ganun siya. Ganun tayo craft ng ating research hypothesis. Lagi lang tandaan, there are two types, null and alternative. Pag null, sinasabi niya na hindi mangyayari. Pag alternative, sinasabi niya na mangyayari. And then there are three elements. We have the variables, the respondents or the group of people being studied, and what? The predicted outcome of that hypothesis. Okay, so that is on how you write research hypothesis. Now, if you want to learn more on how to write research hypothesis, you can open the file with the file name hypothesis or visit the link provided on your learning modules. Okay, so if you do not have any more questions about this lesson, you can start answering activity 4 on your assessment sheets. That's it for our lesson number 3 of Practical Research 2. I hope you learned well in our lesson. Thank you and God bless.